I am Bhupendra Gandhi. I am a senior consultant nephrologist attached to Bridge Candy Hospital, Jastok Hospital and Bhatia Hospital. I am head of the department at Bridge Candy Hospital and director of nephrology at Jastok Hospital. I am also attached to Bhatia Hospital. There are two kidneys present in all patients, all persons. Kidney works, as people know, remove the waste material from the body. It not only removes waste material from the body, but it also helps in fluid metabolism by removing excess fluid from the body. Also, it helps in calcium and phosphorus metabolism, as well as making the red blood cells by producing erythropoietin hormone, and it controls blood pressure. When kidney is damaged, high blood pressure occurs in many patients. These are the common functions of the kidney. Patient requires only 10% of the kidney for survival. Many times when the kidney are not working, patient do not realize it for a long, long time. And kidney produces symptoms only when 60 or 70% or more than that is kidney is damaged. The common symptoms in the patients with chronic kidney disease, what we call it, are swelling of the legs, high blood pressure, low blood count or weakness, nausea, vomiting, itching, other things like these are the common symptoms in the patient with kidney diseases. The symptoms which I mentioned before are the common symptoms for the CKD. These are the weakness, passing less urine, swelling, breathlessness, chest pain on exertion, nausea, vomiting, and weight loss. Itching is also very, very prominent symptoms in the patients with kidney diseases. CKD generally symptoms occurs when, as I mentioned before, when the kidneys are damaged to the extent of 80% or more. Five common causes of kidney failure are diabetes, high blood pressure. These are the commonest cause and constitutes more than 60 to 70% of the patients with chronic kidney diseases. Other causes are what you call collagen diseases like lupus, polycystic kidneys, recurrent urinary tract infection, obstruction of the kidney because of the prostate in the male patients, and the stones or the cancer of the cervix with obstruction in the female patient. And the other common cause which is occurring now more and more common is abuse of drugs, especially the painkillers, which is now getting more and more frequently because patients are using this medication indiscriminately, and also the heavy metals which is prescribed by Ayurvedic people like arsenic, gold and lead. These are the common causes of chronic kidney diseases in the patients. As I mentioned, diabetes and high blood pressure are common causes of renal failure. If you have got diabetes, best thing is to see that you control your diabetes. Diabetes is not only the sugar problem, but it also produces changes in the eyes by producing the retinopathy and blindness, kidney diseases and circulation problem to the legs, producing the requiring amputation or the healing of the leg ulcers in the leg, or stroke. Therefore, diabetes is generalized systemic diseases. And if you have got diabetes, you should control diabetes by diet control, exercises, medications as required, either insulin or anti-diabetic drug orally as required. And the most common cause, which contribute to the control of diabetes is lifestyle modification. You should control your diet and avoid stressful condition. Similarly, high blood pressure, if you have it, you should take it very seriously, because what we have seen time and again is patients who has got high blood pressure, they take the medication for a few days, they check the blood pressure with the medication is controlled, they stop medication. But this blood pressure is controlled because of the medications, and if they take the medication regularly, then only blood pressure is under control. In Western world, blood pressure is known as a silent killer. It doesn't produce the problems in next few years, but after 15 to 20 years time, either it produces stroke, heart attack, or a kidney failure. So that you have to control your blood pressure very well. Previously, people used to say 130, 140, 150, 160, blood pressure is fine. But now, with the more and more data available, we say blood pressure of 120, 130 by 80 is right blood pressure for any age group, with or without medication. Not only you have to take medication, but you have to control your smoking habits, salt intake, and also the ideal weight has to be controlled. Yes, CKD patients, as I mentioned, as components cause diabetes and blood pressure, both produces the heart problem, and also CKD patient has got high level of cholesterol, so they have higher incidence of heart diseases in CKD patients. Other thing is common with the CKD patients are low blood count. That also produces excess stress on the heart, and hardening of the artery produces more chances of ischemic heart diseases and cardiomyopathy. Generally, CKD patient, as I mentioned, will require treatment for diabetes if they have it. If the CKD patient has got diabetes, we prefer to give insulin. So insulin for control of diabetes is very essential. Blood pressure medication, because 60 or 70% of the patients with CKD has high blood pressure. They have to control blood pressure. Other thing, many of the CKD patients have got a low calcium. As I mentioned before, the kidney function related to the vitamin D metabolism, and if they will require higher dose of calcium, and they've got high phosphorus, so that you require phosphate binding agent, and also they require iron therapy and vitamin D supplements. These are common medication prescribed in almost all CKD patients. Any advanced CKD patient, in spite of iron therapy and other things, they have got low hemoglobin, so many of them require erythropoietin injections. These are the common medication prescribed in the CKD patients. Over here, I would like to stress one other thing is many patients require painkiller in the CKD patients. I would like to say that thing that patients with CKD should avoid strong painkiller like all non-steroid anti-inflammatory drug and COX-2 inhibitor, because this damages the kidney further, and if you have it, kidney can get damaged excessively. If you require painkiller, you can take crocin or even Tramazac or Proxivan as required, but that also in a limited quantity only. Patients with kidney diseases, when the kidney function is less than 5 or 10%, only way they can survive is dialysis or a transplantation. There is no third options available to them at all. Unless patient got acute kidney failure, then they may settle down. Generally, there are two types of dialysis are available. One is what you call hemodialysis. In that, we do the purification of the blood by artificial kidney machines. We take out the patient's blood from the patient into the machine via the fistula or the tube or catheter, and this blood is purified, and the purified blood is returned back to the patient via the other needle. This is required minimum twice a week, but ideally three times a week, lifelong. There is no question about it that patient with CKD stage 5, once he is on dialysis, he or she is on dialysis, he will require lifelong dialysis, minimum twice, ideally three times a week. Other options, if patient does not want hemodialysis, he can do what we call a peritoneal dialysis. This is also an option which is good options, where we put in a small tube into the stomach and we wash out the patient's blood by using a what we call a peritoneal dialysis, peritoneal cavity, which is situated in the abdominal cavity. In this, what we do, we put in a solution into the abdominal cavity, it purifies the blood, and we, after 6 hours, we remove this dirty fluid into the bag and repeat the cycle 3 to 4 times a day continuously. Therefore, this is called what we continuous ambulatory peritoneal dialysis, so CAPD in short. This is one way of doing dialysis, which is prevalent in many of the countries like Mexico, where 50-60%, and in UK also 30-40% of the people, but it is not prevalent in India. The reason for this is not prevalent in India is more expensive, and people are afraid of doing CAPD because of rate of infection is higher, and they are worried about life-threatening infection, peritonitis in this. And it's more expensive, as I mentioned. It almost costs 1.5 to twice the normal hemodialysis cost. Other option is a renal transplantation. Renal transplantation is, I would say, the ideal treatment for patient with CKD stage 5. If the person is below the age of 50, 55 or 60, best treatment for CKD is to replace the diseased organ. Therefore, patient has a good quality of life and good quantity of life, better than dialysis patient if the transplant is successful. With the recent availability of the immunosuppressive medication, powerful immunosuppressive medication, our success rate for transplantation is more than 90% at the end of 1 year. If the patient does well for first year or two, they do very well for years together. And our longest patient done on November 1979 is still alive and active. Therefore, he is more than 31 years, probably longest surviving patient, successful transplant patient in India. The transplantation can be done with related donor, what you call live donor, where the related donor like brothers, sisters, parents, children or wife act as a donor, which is legally allowed by government of Maharashtra. Or at times, distant relative may act as a donor where the relative, immediate members of the family are not available. In this, we have to take government permission to do the transplantation because in India, trading of the human organ is prohibited and we have to take the government permission if a distant relative is there. One thing I would like to say over here is transplantation success rate is better, quality and quantity of life is also better. So that once the transplant is done, patient can do very well. Other option is a cadaver transplant where the disease person is dead because of other reasons like trauma, brain hemorrhage, or sometimes sudden cardiac arrest and patient is kept alive on the ventilator and these patients produce brain dead. We can take the kidney out of this brain dead people and put it in the two patients with the CKD stage 5. And two patients can have a normal lifestyle. Unfortunately, cadaveric transplantation program has not taken off very well in India so far because of the public awareness is lacking and we do not have the good infrastructure to keep this brain dead patient alive as per the regulations for 12 to 24 hours before we can take out the kidney. Therefore, this is developing concept and is picking up well. As I mentioned in my kidney function test in the first introduction, kidney manufactures one hormone, what you call erythropoietin, which helps in maintaining the hemoglobin in normal person. When the kidney is diseased or damaged, this hormone is not produced, so the old patients with CKD has got low hemoglobin, anywhere between 6 to 10 grams hemoglobin. This is due to either, as I mentioned, is due to lack of erythropoietin. Other common causes of anemia in the CKD patient are blood loss, because they do have tendency for ulcer in the stomach, or iron deficiency anemia because of repeated blood test or blood loss or inadequate diet. The patient with a low hemoglobin, when they come to us, we evaluate this patient to see they do not have iron deficiency anemia, they are not losing blood from the GI tract, and if they do not have that thing, then only treatment available to CKD patients is take injection erythropoietin. Many times this question is asked, how long do we need erythropoietin? Once you start erythropoietin, you may require erythropoietin in a varying dosages depending upon the response, from 4,000 units a week to 4,000 units two or three times a week, lifelong. Some patients require less and some people require much more erythropoietin injection. The frequency of erythropoietin administration depends upon which type of erythropoietin you are using it. Erythropoietin which you are using generally, which is prevalent being used, is you have to use it maybe once a week to twice a week to three times a week, depending upon the hemoglobin. If the low hemoglobin is there, you require higher dose of hemoglobin more frequently. But once the hemoglobin comes up, you may require once a week or once in 10 days also. But now with the recent introduction of availability of different kind of erythropoietin like darbepoietin or mircera, you can use this erythropoietin maybe once a week or once 2 weeks or once a month also. Therefore, this is required, but this only thing which you have to remember is this medication will be required maybe lifelong till the patient is on dialysis. One of the important causes of kidney is to remove waste material from the body, and one of the thing is the phosphorus level, which is present in almost all food in the which we take it, but mainly in the red meat and the dairy products. We cannot cut down the milk products in majority of the patients, in Indian patients, because they are vegetarian, and only way they get the protein is for the milk and milk products or eggs if they take it. Therefore, majority of the patients have high phosphorus level, so we have to give them a phosphate binding agent. Phosphate binding agent, what it does is combine the phosphorus in the intestine and prevents its absorption, so the phosphorus does not come up. So once the phosphorus comes down, calcium level will have to be restored by giving more calcium, and that will help. If you do not control this phosphorus level, calcium phosphorus, what phosphorus does is phosphorus, by prohibiting the or stimulating the parathyroid hormone, increase the calcium level, and when calcium and phosphorus product goes up, it get precipitated in the skin and produces itching. This is the commonest cause of high phosphorus is itching or red eye, what we call it. And also late stages are vascular calcification occurs that produces stroke or heart attack in the patient with CKD. See, when the patient is on CKD stage 3 or 4, what I said is to control original disease. If they have got blood pressure, diabetes, lupus, infection, blockage, control that as much as possible. Control diet, what you call low protein diet, but do not avoid complete protein. If you avoid protein completely, protein patient will get tremendously weak. So many people go into strict diet and avoiding protein completely, then they do very poorly because of poor nutrition. So they have to take diet control with a good amount of protein, what you call 40 gram protein, out of which 50% should be first class protein like dairy products or eggs or non-vegetarian dishes. And rest of the thing is to control fluid intake. Many people have a common concept that if you take more fluid, they will pass more urine and their urea creatinine will come down. But this is a myth, because kidney has got limited capacity to excrete water. If they take a lot of liquid, they get swelling, breathlessness, and they require early dialysis. So they have to control the liquid, they have to control diet control, avoid excess salt, because salt will produce swelling and high blood pressure. And other thing what you have to avoid is control potassium. Because when kidney disease occurs, potassium level tends to go up. Potassium is a dangerous situation when potassium goes above 6, 6.5, because it can produce sudden death in a patient with kidney problem. So and potassium is present in the fruit juices, coconut water, dry fruits, chocolate. And you should avoid these things or take it as per the potassium level in the blood. If you control this thing, you can prevent or postpone the dialysis by number of months to years. But when the patient goes on dialysis, their diet changes drastically. They can have a near normal diet except for the salt restriction. Liquid restriction remains, because if they take more liquid, they get swelling and breathlessness, and potassium restriction. If they control all these three things, they can have a near normal diet except for the excitement on salt, potassium and the liquid. Dialysis is nothing else but purification of blood. In patient whose kidney is damaged to the extent of 95% or more, requires dialysis. There are two types of dialysis, as I mentioned. One is hemodialysis, that is the blood purification. In other words, it's peritoneal dialysis. In hemodialysis, what we do is to remove the patient's blood from the body into the machine, artificial kidney machine, and the blood is just purified in a dialyzer, and this purified blood goes back into the patient through the other needle, or it is removed from the tube from the neck and purified and returns back from the same other tube in the neck. This is what you call hemodialysis. This other form of dialysis is what we call a peritoneal dialysis. In this, the stomach or the peritoneal cavity is used as a dialyzing material. In peritoneal dialysis, what we do is to put a tube into the stomach. Concentrated solution is put into the abdominal cavity and kept in the abdominal cavity for 6 hours. During this time, the solution is kept in the abdomen for 6 hours. The blood which is going to the peritoneal cavity gets purified, and this dirty fluid, what we call a dialysis fluid, is removed from the body after 6 hours, and the fresh solution is put in. Therefore, this goes on continuously 24 hours a day, the 4 times a day. Every time you put in the solution, keep for 6 hours in this. Therefore, this is what you call a continuous ambulatory peritoneal dialysis. As name suggests, it's continuous 24 hours a day. Ambulatory because patient is moving around for 6 hours when the patient dialysis is occurring, except when dialysis is being solution changed. Peritoneal dialysis, that is CAPD. This is very prevalent abroad, but not done in India to that extent like in Mexico or in United Kingdom. As I mentioned, dialysis is required repeatedly 2 to 3 times a week, lifelong, when the patient's kidney is damaged to the extent of 95% or more. In dialysis, we remove patient's blood at the speed of about 200 to 300 cc blood flow per minute, and this blood is purified. If you have to remove 200 or 300 cc of blood through the human body per minute, it cannot be done in the regular vein because we cannot get more than 5 or 10 cc of blood flow through the machine, through the vein, normal vein per minute. So that we put in a fistula. In that, the fistula is nothing else but connecting the artery in the vein in the hand, either the wrist or at the elbow, and in that artery and vein are connected, so arterial blood goes into the vein. The vein gets bigger, so and more blood is flowing to the vein, so that we can repeatedly puncture this blood and we can get enough blood of going to the machine per minute, 200, 300 cc or more, even 400 cc per minute, lifelong with repeated puncture. Because normal vein, if puncture 2 or 3 or 4 times, it gets clotted. But if the fistula is done and working well, it can work for a number of years. This is what we call AV fistula, which is required to be done in all dialysis patients. And this is the best vascular access for the dialysis patient. But suppose patient comes late in the terminal stage of the kidney diseases and they do not have time to do the fistula, because once you do the fistula, it takes 2 to 4 weeks to mature for the vein to get bigger so we can use it. But if patient requires urgent dialysis, we put a what we call a dialysis, double lumen dialysis catheter, either in the neck or just below the collarbone, and this is done to facilitate dialysis till the pulmonary vascular access is done, like a fistula. The commonest question asked to all patients with all nephrologists is, doctor, how long do I need dialysis and why do I require dialysis so frequently? I will come when I need it. My answer to this thing is, our kidney works 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Ideally, you should be on dialysis 7 days a week, 24 hours at a time or daily. But this is not practical. Minimum frequency required to do well on dialysis is twice a week, but ideally 3 times a week, that alternate day treatment to carry on, and that also to the extent of 3.5 to 5 hours, depending upon the type of dialyzer you use it. So many people can get along with 3.5 hours to maintain 3.5 to 5 hours dialysis 2 to 3 times a week. Longest patient which we had it in Bridge Kennedy Hospital survived for 24 years on dialysis. He was a young person with chronic nephritis. He survived for 24 years, and after 24 years, he died of hepatitis C and cirrhosis of liver, not because of the kidney failure. We have a number of patients who are on dialysis for more than 10 years, and I'm sure all of you must have heard the name of Shammi Kapoor. He's on dialysis for almost 9 years on dialysis. The patient can do well with regular dialysis if they follow the dialysis schedule and follow the diet and the fluid restriction well. Risk of doing dialysis mainly 2 or 3. One is, many times patient gains excess amount of weight, and we try to remove that weight during a short time of 3.5 to 5 hours during dialysis. They gain 4 kilos of weight and we remove 3.5 to 4 kilos during 4 hours of dialysis. When you remove such a large amount of weight during short time, it produces low blood pressure. So they get problem with a low blood pressure. That is the commonest problem we have it. Other thing which we have at times is high blood pressure occurring during dialysis, which is very not frequent. Rigors, which used to occur, but now with availability of what we call reverse osmosis or purified water system, they are doing very well. Other causes are low blood count, chest pain, and breathlessness. That's mainly because of low blood count and excess weight gain or ischemic heart disease. These are the common problems during dialysis. Dialysis patients can have a near normal diet except for, as I mentioned before, salt restriction, because they take a lot of salt, they get thirsty and they drink more water. Fluid restriction of 500 cc to 700 or 800 cc per day. If they drink too much water, they retain water, and then you have to take it out, same amount of water during your dialysis time, so that produces low blood pressure. And also, if you gain too much weight, they produce breathlessness. And the commonest restriction is potassium restriction, which is common in the fruit juices, coconut water, dry fruits, and chocolate. This has to be restricted amount as per the potassium report. So if they have a near normal lifestyle, except for the salt, fluid, and potassium restriction on the diet, which is required. Intense itching is a common problem in CKD patients, even early dialysis patients, early kidney failure patients, and late dialysis symptoms. The reason for this are mainly twofold. One is what we call high calcium, high phosphorus and low calcium level, and hyperparathyroidism associated with high phosphorus and low calcium level. Therefore, this gets precipitated in the skin and produces intense itching. And the other cause is neuropathy, which is very commonly associated with a patient with long-term dialysis patients, because our kidney works very well. Unfortunately, the kidney dialyzer which we use it is good, keeps the patient alive, but it does not remove all the waste material in the body, and some of the middle molecule, what we call, remains in the system, which damages the nerve endings, producing neuropathy. So that produces the tremendous itching on the part of the patient. So the hyperparathyroidism, high phosphorus, and neuropathy, these are common causes of intense itching in the dialysis patient. The way to avoid itching or cut down the itching is control phosphorus level by phosphate binding agent, which is available now in India. Previously, we used to use only calcium carbonate or calcium acetate, but now we have got other products like lanthanum carbonate or 7-MR hydrochloride, which combines the phosphorus in the intestine and prevents its phosphorus absorption, so that calcium phosphorus level does not go up and does not produce itching that much. So that you have to, and by controlling phosphorus, you prevent hyperparathyroidism, so the itching is greatly relieved by this. And if patient got neuropathy, we use what we call a gabapentin or Lyrica, what we call it, for neuropathy, and it helps in the patients with neuropathy. Yes, dialysis patient can travel as long as they make enough arrangement to do dialysis. Many of our patients go out of town for 2 or 3 days or 4 days without dialysis also, because they restrict this diet control very well. They do very well for short term without dialysis for 2 or 3 days or 4 days. But if they are going for a longer time, they should go to the places where dialysis facilities are available. Almost all major cities in India, as well as anywhere abroad, dialysis facilities are available. As long as you tell your doctor concern they can make the proper arrangement and you can get dialysis done anywhere in the world now. And many of our patients are mobile and they work full time, even they go abroad and get dialysis done. Yes, impotency is common in dialysis patient, especially in male patients, because they are not only they've got a low blood count, it produces the less desire. They take a lot of blood pressure medication, which also decreases the sexual power, and also dialysis patients with neuropathy and diabetic patients who have got it because of neuropathy. They have got impotency problem, which is not, is very common. Unfortunately, in India, this to a great extent, underreported because patients are shy of us discussing with the doctor concerned. But it is now getting more and more prevalent. Fortunately, or female patients do have the problem also, but they are being passive partners. They are still a little more active, but male patients do have more problem. Pregnancy in a dialysis patient is very uncommon. If patient dialysis, not that it not, does not occur, it can occur, but you take a special precaution if patient gets pregnant during dialysis, because they will require frequent daily dialysis with a very good control, and then only they can carry it on. Few cases have been reported with the pregnancy with dialysis. With a successful transplant, sexual potency can come back, they can be active, and female patients can get pregnant and can have a near normal pregnancy. You may have to avoid certain drugs like mycophenolate mocktail and some of the blood pressure medication. You have to restrict it during the pregnancy, but they can have a normal pregnancy after the transplantation. See, the what I would like to say that dialysis is a hardship, there's no doubt about it. But I can just say that many times in the life we do not like the things which we like it. Like insulin treatment, if I have diabetes, I have to take insulin 2 or 3 times a day. I may not like it, but if I accept it and take the regular insulin and do continue with regular activity, you can overcome the disease. Dialysis also is a disease, but either disease overcomes you or you overcome the disease. If you overcome the disease by continuing working and accepting dialysis as a part of your life, you can do very well. One of our famous patients, celebrity Sami Kapoor, says, Dr. Gandhi, 3 days in life, 3 days a week is dialysis days, but 4 days are mine to enjoy it. So that's the way I put it. Dialysis is a little difficult time for 3 or 4 hours a day, but if you accept this as a part of your life and do not go on thinking about dialysis next day and you make your life so miserable and your life, patient life miserable, you will do poorly. But you accept dialysis as a part of your life, you will do very well. As I mentioned before, we've got patients, quite in a few number of patients who are more than 10 years, and our maximum number of patients who have survived is more than 24 years. His name also I can say is Hemant Butch, who survived for 24 years. And Anand Dalal, Vikram Philip is 16 years dialysis, Anand Dalal 10 years, Sami Kapoor 9 years on dialysis. These are just to mention 3 of the 4. Just mention Mr. Dalal. He comes Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday to our department. 7:30, at 12 o'clock, he dresses up, puts in a tie, goes back to his office, works till 9 o'clock. Every Wednesday, he goes to Lavasa, where he is building a lot of buildings, because this is his profession, and he works from 5 o'clock in the morning till 11 o'clock, and Thursday morning he is here. Like today morning he was here. So he has accepted life on dialysis, dialysis is part of his life. So you can do very well, and so is, as I mentioned, Sami Kapoor. If you fight with dialysis, you will be miserable and you will make your life and your family also miserable with dialysis. But if you accept dialysis as a part of your life, you can do very well. And now the quality of dialysis is better with the availability of erythropoietin, phosphate binding agent, vitamin D supplements. Patient can have a near normal life with long-term dialysis.